So I wanted to share something super exciting with you guys. So Heather and I have been studying coral reef fish behavior out here in Thailand. This is our second expedition. And one thing that we've noticed is, we're following these fish around, we're paying attention to their social behaviors and how they interact with other fish. And it seems like they often act differently toward one another, or rather they're responding differently to one another when there is a lot of shelter around. This shelter comes in the form of corals. So these corals, they create these large three-dimensional structures that can provide all kinds of hiding places for these fish that are vulnerable to predators. And so it seems like the social interactions of these fish depend on proximity, the distance of these shelters. And so this is seems like a cool pattern that we might want to characterize, because it could be really valuable in understanding the fish behavior. And of course, these fish are valuable to the reef because they clean algae off the reef. So we'd love to get at this in a very quantitative way, measuring it actually with data. And so we're very lucky that some really cool new technology has become available, and it's called structure from motion technology. Basically allows you to swim over a three-dimensional object, or walk over it, or wherever you are. You can have a camera that gets a bunch of different perspectives of that object, and this software, and there's various software platforms available for this, will render a three-dimensional model for you. So we played with this and we've been having some really cool success. So I wanted to show you guys what this is looking like and to tell you a little bit about our plan, which is ambitious to say the least. So let me show you our coral model. This is gonna be a little bit difficult to show you, but I think we'll be able to pull it off. So here is a model of a coral reef that we just generated. And let me zoom in a little bit so you can get a sense for just how amazing this really is. This is about 10 feet by about 40 feet. So oh, there goes Siri. Nope, don't want your help right now. So like I said, about 10 feet by 40 feet. So 3 by about 12 to 13 meters of reef. And so you can see we have a three-dimensional representation of this reef. And it doesn't look particularly exciting right now because, for one, the visibility was not phenomenal. It does look pretty monochromatic, but there are definitely differences here, and you can definitely readily identify live coral versus dead coral and bleaching patterns and these things that we would really want to measure over time. But for us in particular, it allows us to actually very carefully and very precisely measure how much structural refuge is available to these fish. Is this affecting how they are socially interacting with others, with other fish? And so this is super exciting. That was one camera, right? So of course, we're gonna try to go big or go home because we don't have a ton of time out here. So our plan is to mount six cameras across 5 meters, so about 17, 18 feet long pole, and swim over the reef with that pole in a lawnmower pattern, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And we're doing this in collaboration with our good buddies here, Corsi. And it's going to take a village to pull this off, because it's quite ambitious. And as far as I know, and I have some friends actually that introduced me to this technology, that suggests that no one's ever attempted a 3D model of a reef at this scale. So it's, as I said, it's pretty ambitious. Let me just show you very quickly the pole that is going to hopefully allow us to do this. I'm going to disturb Heather for a second, who is working on data. But here it is. This is the end of it anyway. We can't even fit it on our porch because it is a massive piece of aluminum extrusion that we actually bolt together, you can see, and we mount to this a GoPro video camera every meter. And so this allows us to have this sort of massive area that we're covering, and we can basically map very large areas of coral reef with this in 3 dimensions. And use this for our research and for long-term monitoring to understand how this system is responding to tourism, which you can see is extensive right now. So, more soon.